If we fail to understand and take care of the natural world, it can cause a breakdown and haunt us in ways we know little about. Most epidemics of the last decades, AIDS, Ebola, West Nile, SARS, don't just happen. They are a result of things people do to nature. Disease, it turns out, is an environmental issue. 60% of infectious diseases are zoonotic. It means that they originate in animal species and then they spill over into humans. So how did this spillover happen? And why does it happen? Well, every time we alter the landscape, let's say we build a new road, a new farm, or we expand cities to wild areas, we modify natural habitats and facilitate the spillover of viruses from other species into humans. Big urban agglomerations and the globalization in general do the rest to spread the epidemics. Let's give you some proof so you can connect the dots. HIV came from wild hunters in West Central Africa who got the virus from chimpanzees in the 1920s. Hendra in Australia spread in the 90s, a virus with fatality rate of 60% in humans. The spillover happened through horses from a type of bat called flying fox. The reason why such an unusual bat came in contact with humans is that we cut down forests to expand urban areas. Ebola, a viral hemorrhagic fever that kills 50% of those infected, is also believed to have spilled over from fruit bats. Here the main role has been played by the fragmentation of the forest, which has forced different and unusual species to live close together. Nipah outbreak happened in Malaysia, again favored by deforestation, for the creation of intensive farming of pigs. And it's exactly through these pigs that the virus had passed into humans. Most experts believe that there is an increase in zoonotic diseases due to environmental degradation, deforestation, and habitat destruction for industrial production, urban sprawl, and intensive farming. The loss of habitat increases the opportunity of contact between humans and other species, which also changes the dynamic of the transmission of the virus. We disrupt their ecosystems, hunt them, build next to them, grow livestock next to their populations. We allow the viruses they carry that we've never been exposed to in history to emerge in our own populations. Many of us, me certainly included, fell from the cloud, as we say in Italy, when the pandemic hit, meaning that we were shocked about what was happening because we were completely unaware of the circumstances. We thought that the epidemic came from nowhere. Then conspirational theories started to be made up, but we are not gonna talk about that now. So we thought that the epidemic came out of nowhere. But the real question is, were we as humankind really unaware of what was about to come? Let me tell you a little story. In early 2018, during a meeting of the World Health Organization in Geneva, a group of experts coined the term Disease X. They were referring to the next pandemic, which would be caused by a novel pathogen that hadn't yet entered the human population. They said it would likely result from a virus originating in other animal species, be confused for another virus, spread through human network of travel and trades, and so on. Basically, with Disease X, they exactly described COVID-19, 2 years before it happened. But we can go back to 2015, when Bill Gates made that super famous, that went viral, TED talk about our unpreparedness to a potential new pandemic. We can go back to 2012 with the book Spillover by David Quammen to realize that we knew COVID-19 was coming and it was something to be expected. We substitute forests with cereal fields to feed intensive farm animals. We decrease biodiversity. We kill species that would otherwise protect us. Deforestation takes away space to wildlife, and expansion of urban areas pushes humans and wildlife closer together. Concentration of people in urbanized areas with no essential services and global travels and exchange do the rest in creating epidemics. And if we don't adapt our economy model to the natural environment, we should expect more and more epidemics like this one in the next future. We could expect even worse, actually. Can you imagine what would happen if the next one was not a coronavirus, but it was something way more serious, like a hemorrhagic fever? And what if the next pandemic had to happen during an extreme climatic event, which is something that everyone nowadays is expecting to come? Think about how we are tempting fate every day in livestock-intensive farms. We know that antibiotics are selecting stronger and stronger colonies of bacteria. it's just a matter of time that a bacterium develops that we cannot find an antibiotic against. And this is all in addition to the fact that the atmospheric particulate only causes 7 million deaths a year in the world. And we worry about COVID deaths. We need to understand that the COVID pandemic is not something that simply happened to us. We are not the victims. We are the ones who created this situation in the first place, because of the way we live, how we treat the environment, and the choices we make. And when I say we, I mean the entire human population. I think it's essential regarding these matters that we resonate in terms of humankind rather than pointing our fingers at one nation rather than the other, or even worse, politicizing the issue. If we want to control these pandemics, we cannot expect to find a vaccine for each one of them every time. We need first of all to understand that we are not something detached from nature, but we are part of delicate ecosystems that are able to auto-regulate themselves. If we mess with them, that's when these type of problems start to happen. Lastly, let's remember something. This planet and its ancient inhabitants have been here forever before humans started to colonize it. If we continue to over-exploit natural resources as we are doing, who's gonna disappear is not planet Earth. It's the human species. Hi everyone, this is Mary Jane, and this is the third video of a trilogy about COVID and environment that I created in the last couple of months. If you think the message I'm trying to spread is valuable, please help me in that. Share this video in your social media accounts and let YouTube know that it's a video worth watching by giving it a like and leaving a comment down below. All the resources I've used for this video are linked in the description below. I invite you to check them out and go deeper into the topic. That way you can also understand that there is a whole lot of work and research that goes into these type of videos, and I do everything for free. So if you feel like giving me a small financial support, everything is very well accepted. I have a Patreon page and I also leave a PayPal link down below. Lastly, I invite you to go check out the first two videos of this trilogy if you haven't yet. In the first one I made, I analyzed the question whether COVID is good or bad for the environment. In the second one, I'm talking about how COVID is affecting the world's economy, especially in the oil field and renewable energies. It's all for today. I'll see you in my next video. Bye! I almost forgot to mention that I'm gonna filter the comments of this video. The rules are no hate comments and no pointing fingers to entire nations. Especially comments about how China is responsible for COVID-19 are gonna be deleted unless very well argued. Any thoroughly argued comment will be, in general, very much appreciated.